I think, sir, the elegance of the surgery was very beautiful. Your thought process, and it was very masterful. Everybody has a different way of looking at things. The trick here for flipping was you could relax the capsulotomy by making the nicks radial nicks. That's the secret why the nucleus could be flipped out easily, because rexus is the barrier which prevents the nucleus from coming out easily. But lovely having said that, I have one issue of compromising the rexus, because doing those nicks, I would have tried to enlarge the rexus by making a much more bigger one, here circumlinear cut and do it, because I would want to protect the rexus margin until the last, because if you have a lax zoneus, I could use a CTR. But once the rexus is compromised, I can't use a CTR inside. Secondly, the long-term centration, refractive predictability is all much more better once we know that the lens is sitting perfectly well in the back. That's the only thing. I would be very, mindful of trying not to sacrifice the rexus. That would be my last resort. That would be my last resort. Because rexus has got too many advantages to just go let off it. That's the only thing. Otherwise, it was just a superb surgery.
I'm not cataract surgeon, but will you not plan the rexus before going in for rexus, depending upon the nuclear hardness?
Absolutely, sir. You have to have as big of a rexus as possible. That is the whole key here.
In this particular case, there was the hard nucleus and the pupil was already going smaller. So we had to do it this way.
With the size, the sheer size of the nucleus, no rexus would have permitted a flip. You can watch Blumenthal n number of times and you'll realize that most of the cataracts he dealt with were never this big in terms of diameter. So here your diameter of the lens was so large that I'm sure there was no other option but to have nicks in the capsule.
If you use a bimanual way of wheeling out the nucleus, where you use two Sinskyukes, push the nucleus down, one hook goes under the equator of the nucleus, then lift one pole out and then wheel the nucleus out. If you follow this technique, you can get the bigger diameter nucleus also along with a smaller opening.
The nucleus was so big that we just couldn't hazard a surgical strike going so far in the equator to find out the equator of that nucleus, one thing. And the other point I was, a different point, I would suggest to all people who are going in for SICS, don't go in for very small tunnels, because
you're there.
Either if you don't know how to bisect the nucleus in the AC or in the bag. So bisection is to be learned first, then the tunnel is supposed to be brought.
Okay. Point made, Ranjit.